When I gaze upon the clear dark sky, I have no need to wonder why that point of light arcs gently through the night. It is no symbol or portent, no harbinger supernaturally sent. There is no need for me to guess. I know it is the ISS. When Cernan left the final tread upon the moon and claims, he said, "Let's get this mother out of here." He did not speak those words with fear. His faith and trust in engineers, backed by science, eased his fears. On the shoulders of giants, Gene reached his peak, but not the giants of which myth and legends do speak.
Ignition sequence started. All engines are started. We have ignition, 2, 1, 0. We have a liftoff. We have a liftoff, and it's lighting up the area. It's just like daylight here at Kennedy Space Center as the Saturn V is moving off the pad. It has now cleared the tower.
When Werner Magnus Maximilian Freiherr von Braun stated 80 years ago, "I plan on travelling to the moon," Auguste Piccard did not respond with mirth, because von Braun was working with Oberth. The year Albert's relatives modified Isaac's rules, Hermann Oberth was getting hooked on jewels. He saw how fiction could be made into fact using calculations which scientists had made exact. And Einstein sat at the head of a line which disappeared back into the shadows of time. Planck, Lorentz, Maxwell, Joule, Faraday, Dalton, Michelson, Morley, Lavoisier, Boltzmann. Each of them giants in their own rights, adding to science with their great insights. They followed the facts wherever they led, epitomized in what Alexander Pope said,
"Nature and nature's laws lay hid in night. God said, let Newton be, and all was light."
And Newton was genius, albeit with flaws, but science is science and laws are laws. On the shoulders of giants, even Isaac was seated. A list too long to be fairly repeated. Kepler, Boyle, Hooke, Brahe, Galileo Galilei, Copernicus, and many names now lost to history. The Arabs, Greeks, Egyptians, and Babylonians left word, and deeper into history, before there was written record. To the very first human who tried to explain the sky at night, we owe a debt of gratitude for shining the first light. It has been a long road to get to where we are. Our evolved superstition ensures we still must travel far. But if one thing can disperse the shadow of remaining ignorance, it is surely spreading the light of scientific brilliance.